Hello everyone, Sunday live stream, good morning, it's good to see familiar faces. I'm just checking to see if I'm stuck. I don't think I'm stuck. I think everything is still working. Good. Thanks for joining. Those of you that are new, we have about an hour of music and questions, usually around music and the accordion. Feel free to chat, feel free to ask questions. I try and monitor the chat fairly closely, so I'll write down questions as they appear. Welcome. Thanks for attending. Thanks for coming. I wanted to start with a question. Is it Mia? Yeah, Mia was asking, when I play Hallelujah, I like to use legato bass technique, but there are big jumps with the left hand, so it breaks the constant sound that I try to keep. How can I try to avoid that? So, let me jump into a question real quick. So, legato bass technique, I'm going to take it to be this. Right? The quick answer is I think you might need to break the sound very slightly, but it will be indiscernible to the ear, to the listener. So, the C major to A minor is a big jump to keep the legato bass technique. I'll demonstrate. Right? So, just again, to differentiate, staccato is light. Staccato, legato. Right? So, I heard. How does one move to the A minor without breaking the sound? Let me play it through a few times and you'll see that there is a break in the sound, but especially if I'm playing melody, it will cover up the break. So, on the way back, my finger's already reaching. It's on A minor and here I'm already at the C, so there won't be a break. It's very minor. I'm just going to go C minor to A minor back and forth. Just C minor to A minor. And I'm going to try and make the break smaller and smaller. It seems that there's a break whenever we move up from the F to the G. So again, some practice that I would do, Mia, is just try and make the break as small as possible. Just do C to G. Then C to D minor, right? We're bringing that incremental step. C to D minor. There is a slight hiccup, but again, if I'm playing melody, it's small. Right, so when you're going down from the A minor to the F or the A minor to the C, while you're pressing the A minor, slide your finger over to the C already. Slide your finger over to the F already. Right? And when going up, there will be hiccups. I don't think there's a way of not having the hiccups. The trick is just to work on making the gap smaller and smaller. Good. I'll pause there. That was a quick lesson off the bat. I had a feeling, Mia, that you had to leave. Am I right? I can't stay long today. I'll ask my question now. Good. I hope that answers your question. Good. Hello, everyone. Now I finally get to say hello. We have lots of familiar faces. Hello. I'm happy to see you here, Ray. Hello, my mom from our living room. Amazing. Thank you for joining. I think, thank you, good, okay, good. It was quiet, so I didn't know if I was frozen or not, but it sounds good. Hallelujah Legato gets a check mark. We have lots of things I want to discuss today, lots of questions and songs. The dryer just went off, so it could be a bit quieter now. So a few things. I'll give you a little bit of my agenda just so I speak about it too. So someone requested to figure out the Mull of Kintyre. It's a song by Paul Cartney about Scotland. We're going to do some Forest Flowers together. We watched the Dolly Parton song, I Will Always Love You, which I thought was a Whitney Houston song. But my wife was like, no, it's a Dolly Parton song. And anyways, we watched a Dolly Parton documentary and she sings it and it's beautiful. So we'll play it together. I'll address the question about bellow control. And then we'll talk a little bit about the new website too. Yeah, and Hallelujah is a great song to learn because there's some big jumps. That A minor to the F is a big jump. Same as the Valse d'Amélie. Good. If you have questions, let me know. Hello, and thank you for sharing all those chromatic accordion resources. You know what? Let's jump straight to the forum. So every week, you accordion fans and students, you share a lot of great information with me, I think with each other over here. And so it's been requested to start an accordion forum. You want to keep this conversation going throughout the week. You continue the conversation with me, and I love that. And so I've built two forums. I'm probably just going to go down to one forum. A forum is like a community message board on Accordion Love, and it's just a place for you to continue the conversation. Anyone will be able to look at the public forums, which are accordion chat, accordion lessons, general chat, etc. We'll have a private forum, which is only open to Accordion Love members, where if you want to upload your playing and receive feedback, that's great. But just going back to Anne's resources, I sent out an email Friday with a link, with a set of links that Anne shared with me, but I thought, wouldn't it be nice to just have a thread in a forum called Chromatic Accordion Resources, and Anne can share all her resources, and someone else can say, hey, here's another PDF that I found, and someone else can say, hey, I found that book wasn't so great, but here's a video that really helped me. So that's coming next week. A few of you have volunteered to be moderators and sort of look through the threads and help people out. Thank you. Yeah, so that's forum out of the way. That's coming next week. You'll be able to use your Accordion Love login to log in and post to the forum. Yeah, good. You think you'll ever get a tone chambered accordion? Oh, I would love to. My dream is to go over to Martin's shop and just to ask him if I could sit down with a tone chambered accordion. I think those are the ones with, I don't know the explanation, but they sound big and full and wonderful with a right hand, right? Good. Let's play some songs, too. I played Christmas songs, but I won't do it now. Hello, Food for Fun. Let's do... So it's we've just played like three kind of sad songs, and the comment is, can you play please something happier? Tennessee Waltz. I'll play the Tennessee Waltz in a happier way. Shouldn't be a happy song. Yeah, trying to play a joyful Tennessee waltz. Like Jen said, it's a sad song because her best friend took my sweetheart from me. Yeah. Let me plug in the light. The light broke. 1 second. Sorry, I'm showing you my back for a second. Ha ha, there we go. Very good. Oh. This used to be an old, this little live stream studio, my office, is an old closet, and so everything is kind of jerry-rigged. Yeah, there's like, anyways, you saw the old dining room chair, and I like it very much. Someone called it a dungeon once, back to the dungeon. yeah, so those of you with a tone chamber accordion, is it just the right hand that's a tone chamber, or is it the left hand? I don't understand it. I'm sure I could do some reading, but Douglas, you have two. Does it make a big difference? Hello, Sally Ann. Thank you. Oh, you'll be uploading an Elton John song today. Which one? Is showing your back considered a bad thing? I think it's just... Show your face to the audience, right? Jim Morrison sang with his back to the audience, but he was Jim Morrison. Yeah. Let's do... I'll address some questions. Obviously, if you have more requests, write them in. I'll monitor it. Yeah, the old man cave. Okay, so we had a few questions. A student made a really good comment. I'm not going to share your name. I was telling my wife, I'm like, oh, he played it really nicely. And she said, oh, maybe you shouldn't mention his name. But someone made a comment, I'll share my screen too, which was going back to basics was important for them. I think they, I'll show you what I mean by back to basics. I'll screen share. And I have a back to, actually, I don't need to screen share. I could just tell you. Going back to basics, I have a few lessons about Ode to Joy and playing your first song by ear and making large bass jumps. I'll take 3 minutes to talk about this. And this student went back to those basics and he said how good it is to play those basic songs. And in my head, the analogy is what we're doing with the accordion, playing songs, especially Tennessee Waltz and Hallelujah. We're doing multiplication and fractions and long division, and it's not an easy thing, right? We're playing songs is like we're speaking a language. We're doing operations in mathematics. Going back to basics is just a reminder of numbers and addition and subtraction. And everything else comes from those foundations. So going back to basics, I think is important, depending on where you are in your learning journey. Again, thank you, Adrian. Mia's question about the legato bass without making breaks. How I would practice it is bringing it from a C to a G. It's incremental bass jumps, right? Someone asked me the question, now I will share my screen, about incremental bass jumps, and it's in your wrist movement. So level two, beyond the basics, this is accordionlove.com. Under advanced left-hand technique, making large bass jumps. This is just, how do we incrementally make larger bass jumps? How do we do our wrist movement? Is it a slide or is it a stretch? So just really making sure that everything's nice and tight. Going back to the basics is that when you are stumbling somewhere, how can we go back a step and back a step and back a step? And ultimately what it comes down to is my finger in the right position? Do I know the C major to A minor? Do I know the legato bass technique? Can I connect them? Oh, there's a break in the sound. And what Mia did was ask. And the answer is, yes, there is a break in the sound. It's unavoidable, but we can make that break tiny so it's indiscernible to the ear. So this student went back to the basics. The lesson is go back to the basics. The lesson that I want to share, let me share my screen again, is it's called Ode to Joy, Accordion Love, Play by Ear. Imagine we all spoke like we Google. So this is just accordionlove.com, play by ear, song memorization. And this is just how do we learn a song, a guide to memorizing accordion songs. I do share the example of Ode to Joy. The sheet music is here too, if you learn by sheet music. But these are just the foundation, the basics. Here's how to approach learning a song. And again, that's accordionlove.com. And we have a new accordionlove.com. There was often the question is, how do I get to these blog posts? I know they're there, I just can't find them. Let me open an incognito window. Actually, will it work? Anyways, if you go to accordionlove.com, those blog posts, the playing by ear, the ear training exercises, the guide to coordinating hands is all on the front page now. So there, you can find them now. Yeah, and I think the form will be exciting too. Good. Oh, amazing, Mike. Mike, are you on the island? Are you going to Martin's store itself, or is he shipping the accordion to you? Congrats. How can I play louder with a right hand while playing legato with a bass, since the bass is way louder? Help. Hi, Axel. Volume control is tough. So I heard this question before. This is Axel's question. It could be an issue with the accordion, but here's what I would do, Axel. Choose your master sound. If you have three sounds, the one in the middle, your loud sound, right? And just play your right hand, right? Just play Mary Had a Little Lamb. Just that's loud. When you play staccato, when you play like this, is the right hand louder? Assuming yes, that's good. And then when you play legato, there's a way of playing loud legato and soft legato. I could play loud legato by pulling hard, or I could play soft legato by not pulling so hard. And then the question is your right hand still louder and softer? I think the trick is to play the master sound. If I use a thin sound with only one reed, it gets lost in the mix a little bit. But I have a lesson. I'll share my screen again. I'll go to search. It's called volume. Is it called volume? Playing dynamics and volume control. And it talks a little bit about volume control on the accordion. When you're playing pure legato, see if you could use the master sound, but otherwise, introducing rests to double check that your volume, that your right hand is loud enough, and to for the listener to be able to pick out the melody, and a little bit of volume control. So balancing volume through dynamics. Can you go loud and quiet for the melody to shine through? If the whole song is loud, let me stop sharing my screen. If the entire song is loud, it's really tough to pick up the nuance. So even with legato, play with loud and quiet and see if you can make your melody shine through, if that's your intent. Good. Shalom, Tamar, good to see you. It sounds more balanced to your listeners than when you're playing. Yeah, that too, right? The sound's coming out of here rather than up here. Good. That was a question about back to basics, Ode to Joy. Let me try and play the Dolly Parton song, I Will Always Love You. Again, my wife and I watched the Dolly Parton documentary. I thought I Will Always Love You was a song by Whitney Houston. That's the song I play in my head. And to hear Dolly Parton's version, oh, it's just, they're both beautiful, but I think I have a new favorite version of the song. Let's play it. I saw her, hello Chris, I saw her play guitar and she was playing a D major. So let's play the song in D major. I Will Always Love You by Dolly Parton. I tried to throw some Whitney Houston in there. I bumped it up plus one unexpectedly to the E major, and it worked. It's a beautiful song. Yeah, thanks for not doing Jolene. That's cool. My parents are senior citizens in Arizona, home for months due to the pandemic. I call them every Sunday to play for them. That's wonderful, Connie. That's wonderful that you're playing for them. Hello, Jackson. Hello, Jackson. Good to see you. Someone was asking, yeah, I'm happy there's a discussion about chromatic accordion. Good, thank you. I live in Vancouver, but I'm making the trip to Martin Starr on Sunday. Need to hear and play what I buy. Awesome, Mike. If it was a different time, I would love to come down and meet you too and go to Martin Starr, but it's still a little strange. Let's do Let's figure out together. Someone was asking about the Mall of Kintyre. They were having a bit of trouble figuring out the chords. I had to listen to it yesterday. Let's play together. Let's figure the song out together. I'll share the screen. Oh, someone was asking for the Blade Runner music. Mall of Kintyre. We'll spend 2 to 3 minutes. I've listened to Glenn Campbell. I've listened to the Paul McCartney. Let's take 5 minutes and listen. Ba, ba. Our one chord, our main chord in the song is A major. That's what they're... Right? You hear that, maybe?
Mall of Kintyre.
Ba, 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 ba. Right, so from our one, from our A, we went to the D. I'm just gonna tell my student the chords for a lesson on figuring out songs by ear. I have a few on YouTube.
The sea.
Back to the
my
A.
Desire is always to be on Mall of Kintyre.
I missed the chord there, but let's keep playing.
Far have I traveled, and much have I seen. Dark distant mountains with valleys of green. Painted deserts, the sun sets on fire as he
can. Back to D.
Has painted deserts, the sun sets on fire as he can.
So, A, D, with a quick change to an E to the A. It's a 1-4-5 song form. Let's listen to the chorus together. Sorry if you know the song, you're watching me struggle through it. If you don't know the song, sorry that you're watching me struggle through it. Are we standing up? Where are you going?
Mall of Kintyre, oh mist rolling in from the sea. My desire is always to be here, on Mall of Kintyre.
Okay, I'm gonna switch back to me. Oh my god, right? He's so young, just Paul's voice. Oh, can you imagine? And then, yeah, so A to D to A, and eventually he does a ba 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 da 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 da. If you're studying the song, I forget who the student was, they messaged me yesterday. I hope this helps, but follow up with me over email if you're watching. Good. That homeowner's wondering why there's a hairy band out on the lawn, right? It's like, where were you going, Paul? Oh, they're leaving. Oh no, he's joining with another musician. Get off my lawn. Jackson, thanks for being here. If you don't watch Jackson Parodi, you should. He's in the chat. He has a Twitch stream. He plays music every day. You would have seen his accordion covers on YouTube. And he plays beautiful, beautiful piano. He takes requests like me. And he sings along and just super wholesome stream and ultra witty. A Tarantella. Yeah, let's play Tarantella. Let me show you the new search. So there's a new search on... Thanks for being you. Awesome. Let me show you the new search. So on Accordion Love, there are a few places for search that aren't working right now, but search-site, I search for Tarantella, and it's an autocomplete. So and it shows you the Tarantellas. Oh, Luna Mezzomare, beautiful. You click into it, and obviously it takes you to the actual song. And then you get the sheet music too. And right now you're in the Italian section, so you have all the songs that I've labeled Italian. But in general, the search is super powerful. I like it better than the old search. And my developer has made these searches work now too. We'll implement it Monday because I didn't want him to make a change and for the site to break during the live stream. So let's do Luna Mezzomare. That's a nice song. I switched the key, so it's tough. We'll be right back. I know, that's what I get for showing off, but I'm trying to, I'm not trying to show off. I was trying to connect it to the previous song, and because we were in E major or A major, like, oh, let's keep going. So those were two tarantellas. Funiculi funicula wasn't a tarantella. Before that, we played Luna Mezzo Mare, the song from The Godfather, where the grandfather and the grandmother are singing Luna Mezzo Mare or Pisce Fritte Baccala. Thank you, Jen. Thank you for the donation. Let me talk about the illustrations a little bit. So my site has a front page, accordionlove.com, which is like the old front page, but it's updated. And then the illustrations were done by a person named Silent James. He's illustrated for the New York Times. He's a very, very talented illustrator. He's illustrated children's books. That's why I found out about him. And I got him to illustrate the sections of the website. There was some initial concern by a lot of people about the illustrations being a bit childlike, and I hear that. My hope is that there are no illustrations on accordionlove.com, the website, so hopefully people have an idea of the level of songs and explanation that there is. It's not targeted at children, but I understand the confusion of getting to the lessons page and seeing the children's illustrations and saying, like, oh, this is targeted towards children. I love them. I've tried to, working with James, we've tried to keep it gender neutral and just to have a variety of people of all ages and colors. And yeah, these are my two kids playing children's songs. Anyways, if you're interested in working with them, superstar, just super approachable and happy to deliver on time and on budget. This is available to everyone. Have a look through the site, again, accordionlove.com. You can access it by clicking the lessons button at the top. If you're not logged in, at the top, there's a button called lessons, and that shows you the lessons. Good. That's all I'm going to say about Accordion Love. I'm super happy to finally finish it, to have a version available, because now I can switch attention to other things. And that's my next question. Aside from this chat, just what do I, obviously we'll get a forum going, but what do I put my time towards? Part of me, I have a list of requests from students like you. That's probably 150 songs deep. Let's call it 100 songs. And I kind of pick and choose from there, right? Every week when I'm like, what lesson should I do? I pick from there. I'm wondering if I should just do like a song a day for 3 months and just figure the song out by ear and post it. That might happen. I still need to think about that. Can I play Cass's theme? Yes, let's play Cass's theme. Any good resources you may recommend for reading sheet music? Mike, I'm the wrong person to ask. Other people. I know flashcards are great, but I don't read sheet music well. So I don't have good resources. Beautiful chord. Let's play Cass's theme. Theme from Breath of the Wild, the Zelda game. My son came home, my 6-year-old, and he said, Abba Dad, there's a game called Breath of the Wild. Man, I think it'll be exciting to play video games with my kids, these bigger games. Good. We did I Will Always Love You. We did Mall of Kintyre. I want to address some of the questions. Oh, a student had a question about bellow control. I have a lesson about, can you play the Song of Storms? I don't know it. Jackson Perotti. Jackson, I hope I'm pronouncing your last name. If you Google Song of Storms in all keys, Jackson Perotti, the other accordion player, there are lots of accordion players, the accordion player does the song in all 12 keys. And it's amazing to see. He does it in one take. So imagine I play Where Do You Go to My Lovely, right? And I'm going to switch to D major. Now to E major. He does Song of Storms in all 12 keys, and he doesn't do it in an easy way. I think he does it beautifully. After this stream, do Song of Storms in all keys by Jackson Perotti, and prepare to have your mind blown. That was Zelda, yes. Sorry if this has been covered, but are the songs meant to be ordered in level of difficulty as they are displayed in each section? No, Jack Burton. I try to include difficulty. Sorry, I guess I can. This is such a technical thing. I'll talk about it for a minute. I can have difficulty level per course. What does that mean? So level one, the basics, right? I'm just opening it up in another tab. I could say that this is an easy course. This is a course. Within courses, I have sections, and within sections, I have lessons. I can't say that legato bass technique is difficult within an easy course. So I've labeled beyond the basics as intermediate, right? These are all intermediate things. When we get to a section like European, Russian, Nordic accordion songs, there's no way to easily categorize this. I have a developer right now working in the background who lets me add a tag to, let's call it forest flowers, right? But I can just have basically a text label here that says forest flowers. And here I could just have plain text that says this is an easy song. This is an intermediate song. Or this song is a 6 out of 10. Here are some prerequisites. In general, though, while we're on the topic of which songs should I start with. Oh, where is it? I think it's under the basic. Sorry, we're jumping around a bit. Your first accordion songs. I think it's under the most effective ways of learning songs. There's this thing called Help Me Choose My First Accordion Song and Why It Shouldn't Be a Waltz. And there are a bunch of things on how to learn and how to learn a song in general. In general, I recommend that your first songs should not be a waltz. Do I write that somewhere? This is in the video. And I'll repeat it again as to why it shouldn't be a... Sorry, your question was, are the songs ordered in order of difficulty? No, they're not. It's getting there. I have a developer working on adding a difficulty, so you'll be able to use the site search for intermediate and see all the songs that are intermediate. Easy and see all the songs that are easy. I think it's probably a good thing to order them in the meantime by difficulty, but it'll be hard to tell where the break is. Because a song between intermediate and hard is a big jump. Between easy and intermediate, it's like going between addition and subtraction, and all of a sudden you're entering multiplication. Usually that's the jump from songs like... to a waltz. It's an order of magnitude that you just need to settle into. So I haven't gotten around that challenge yet with a new site. Good. That's a thorough answer. Mull of Kintyre, I'm a street entertainer and always go straight into the Skyboat songs from from it as a little medley. Cool. I didn't know Mull of Kintyre, but that's good to know. Let's do, good. I'm a little bit distracted. I was going to answer a question about bellow control. A student had a question about bellow control. I'm just going to read it. I'm not sharing my screen. Good. And the question was, I have a video about bellow control where I say it's okay to stutter. We pull bellows this way, and it kind of opens like a V. The top opens more than the bottom. And then I push in, and it's like an upside down V. And that's unintentional. So your question, do I have to practice that for when I try to do that? There's too much pressure making too much sound. Practice it however you'd like. When I get going and my bellows is out here, and I lift my foot up to get it back, I'm okay with that. That happens in a performance. I'm okay. I feel it's like if someone is singing and they're reaching back, I don't think it's good for the singer. But if you find yourself doing that, do it once in a performance. In general, as long as it's consistent volume, as long as you can control the volume from low to high to low, and in that you find your phrasing and you change direction, that's okay. So I see you doing that when your bellows open pretty very far. Is that correct? Sure. Do I have to practice that for when I try to do that? There's too much pressure, making too much sound. Don't worry about it. I'm addressing the student. Don't worry about it. Aim for that consistent and flowing sound. And when you see that there's a stutter, if there's a song and you keep closing the bellows, that's when you could say, hey, I keep getting to this position and I have no more sound. Let me change things up. Good. I hope I see there's lots of chat. I hope you're helping each other out. If I see a song that I know, I'll play it. But otherwise, I don't know a lot of these songs. Oh, and you're on the chat. Good. I tried to keep you anonymous, Evo. Let's play Where Do You Go To My Lovely in B-flat, because we haven't played in B-flat, and we'll see where it goes.
Swimsuit, you get an even suntan on your back and on your legs. And when the snow falls, you're found in some of these where the others of the jet set. Lovely, when you're alone in your bed, Tell me the thoughts that surround you. I want to look inside your head, yes I do.
Yeah, that's Where Do You Go To My Lovely. It's such a great song. Good. Closing and opening the bellows. We did I Will Always Love You. Great. Good. Jack, you're working for the Eastern European section? Cool. If I was to look at the Eastern European section, let's go back. Polkas are easier than waltzes. There's a closer connection between your right and left hand, right? That's all it does, right? Easier than... Because on a waltz, your right hand is trying to fit more notes than what your left hand is doing. So it's just a little bit of a barrier to entry. But if you find it okay, great. So Leven Polka is easier. Katyusha is easier. Beer Barrel Polka is easier. Da, 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 da. These ones are straighter, as well as Blue Wagon, Blue Wagon. Moscow Nights is also more straightforward. I would designate those as easier, not easy. And then Forest Flowers. Dark Ice could be categorized as an easier version too. Forest Flowers is more difficult. Stranger in Paradise is more difficult just because of the song. So what makes a song more difficult? Either that it's complicated putting its hands together because of its rhythm mostly, or in the case of Stranger in Paradise, we look at the chords. Look at that, my old apartment. The chord changes take you to places that aren't so obvious. And so I would designate that, especially here with the E-flat minor and the B. This pushes it up into the intermediate rather than easier category. Katyusha, easier. Talianska, oh, that's not easy because it's a waltz and it has some beauty. I would encourage you to learn it. And I don't remember Sir Joseph, and I don't know how to pronounce it. Good, I hope that answers. Blue Lagoon, yeah, someone play Leven Polka. Let's play Leven Polka. And yeah, a Russian person requested it for me. What was it? It's a crocodile and Blue Wagon. It's a crocodile and maybe Suklamin 3 can answer. It's a crocodile and something else. We said Leven Polka. Leven Polka. Let's play it in C minor. Thank you. Oh, how does it go? That was Blue Wagon. Ronin's on the loose again. That was Blue Wagon to Ochechornia to Black Eyes to... We did a bunch of that Eastern European section of Accordion Love. All the chic music is on Accordion Love. More importantly, this is my spiel. All the lessons have... Here's the lesson, right? Here's the song. There's also how to learn the song, which in my mind is more important than it. What is this like? Math. Going back to the math analogy. I'm going to do one of those analogies again. Imagine trying to learn math. You can get a math teacher. Great idea. Get a piano or accordion teacher. Or, you know, you do a Google search and you find the sheet music. And that's like buying a math book. And you're great at reading the question and kind of following along with the solution. The sheet music is the solution. It's important to have the solution. It's important sometimes to look at the solution to double check that what you're doing is correct. Really, look at that mustache. Really, what's important is the lesson. What's important, I'm tuning my own horn here, the teacher that explains how to think about the song. How do we approach a song like Blue Wagon? This is a sheet music playthrough where I go, oh, here's the turnaround that happens, and here's the fingers that I use. The sheet music is there. Again, this is the easy part. This is four lines. But doing this, you know, I could play this, okay. Does it mean that I'm performing the song? No. Again, use the sheet music. This is my little spiel. Use the sheet music. But really what I encourage you to do... I'll say his name, Guy, who's not on this who's not here today for whatever reason, I hope he's okay, requested Harvest Moon. And so when I sent him the tutorial, I'm like, guy, thank you so much. Here's Harvest Moon. He said, I just watched the lesson twice. And it was a 15-minute lesson, right? Most lessons are 12 to 13 minutes. This is a 8-minute lesson. Okay, it's an easier song. Sit down and just watch the lesson. If I wish I did this in school. Just really learned how to do, you know, fractions, multiplications, a little bit easier. It wasn't the math book. It was the teacher that I learned the lesson from. So that's my spiel about Accordion Love. Thank you, Ford. Very nice. Thank you. Can you play major songs in minor or minor songs in major? Sure, Komka. On accordion, playing major songs in minor is the easiest thing to do. I've never played it, but let's do it. Let's do it. So let's start with Ode to Joy. We know that Ode to Joy, we'll start with two chord songs. C major. La 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 la. C major to G major, let's do those in minor.
C minor to G major.
I'm just singing it before I'm playing it, but Ode to Joy, let's play major songs and we'll switch to minor halfway. Thank you, Anne. That's a major song to a minor song. I think it gets more difficult, but in general, I say it's easier on accordion because you're doing the same motions, but to switch from a major to a minor, it's just major. Move this finger down, and it's a minor. So it's easier to sing, right? Where do you go to, my lovely? Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. It's already a minor song, but I could do... It's a bit harder, but for songs that are easier, that have just a few chords, it's easier to do the major songs and minor. Ode to Joy for 2020, I agree. Let's do a few of those songs. Let's do Creep by Radiohead. Because it's major to another major, to another major, to a minor. So you got to switch around the chords. Good challenge. That's a good challenge. Hello, my Uncle D from Promenade Mall in Thornhill, Ontario. I'll keep... Oh, God, Resty Merry Gentleman is both major and minor, is loads of fun. Yeah, lots of chord changes. Yeah, Jack Burton saying something very true. What helps me... is to go ridiculously, ludicrously slow. Like, if it's 120 beats per minute and I'm learning a section, I seriously go at like 20 beats per minute. Yes. Yeah, I agree with you. I agree with you. For coordinating hands together, will my screen show if it's a new window? I have a guide to hand coordination. Guide to hand coordination, Accordion Love. If you do this in Google, the how-to guide to coordinating your hands on the accordion. There are a few exercises. I was showing my wife. I have a desire to teach my wife accordion in a week, just the right and left hand. She doesn't play music. And I explained to her, it's doing this. It's doing this, rubbing your belly and tapping your head. This is coordinating your hands on the accordion. It totally is that. It's doing two things separately. And then that guide has a few exercises on how to do that. Trying to do We Three Kings of Orient are in major. Yeah, I like it, right? Jingle bells in a minor key? Great ideas. Really confusing people. It does feel like a 2020 should have minor Christmas songs. That's fun. That's good. Sad Russian bells. I feel like jumping off the sleigh. Sorry. I think my family's back. I'll wrap it up. I might do one or two more songs. We try and do this every Sunday. Majority of the stuff that I play is on accordionlove.com. Again, the important thing about Accordion Love and being accordion students is understanding things. I think in anything you do in life, we memorize certain things. But in general, if you could... Anyways, my little spiel. I want you to be able to play music. I want you to be able to express yourself with your instrument. And I'm here to help you. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to say about that. Thank you for those of you that came. I'll keep playing a little bit. Beautiful. What about to write it sound like Jingle Bells in A minor? Yeah. That was Jingle Bells in minor. What other happy Christmas songs on there? Here comes Santa Claus in minor. Right.
Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus way. Always merry and bright, 'cause Santa Claus is coming tonight.
So the reason they sung like Russian songs or what, I mean, how do I put this in a politically correct way? We can generalize music styles. We can say that klezmer sounds like this. We could say that tangos, Argentinian tangos, sound like this. What makes them sound like that is obviously rhythm, but the form of the song. Klezmer goes from a major, minor one, to a major. Tangos typically go from a... that, right? To a major, to a minor four. Russian songs start in a minor key, typically. Again, I'm generalizing musical styles, right? So... to a major 5, to a minor 4, to a major 5, landing on the 1. So, that sounds Russian. I'm also giving that intonation. Blues can sound like that, right? I went down to St. James Infirmary. It's just a little bit of a slower tempo. We have that same minor 1-5 minor 1 as a Russian song, right? But that doesn't sound like blues. There's my blues. Bluesy rhythms and generalizations of songs. Good. Thank you, everyone. I'm gonna go downstairs. I think the family's here. Yeah, thank you for coming. If you have any questions that I didn't get to, send me an email, ronan@accordionlove.com. I love getting your emails. I'm sometimes a bit slow in getting to them, especially last week with pushing the site live. I just had, every day there was a little fire. The search didn't work. This wasn't working. So it was just doing that. So sorry if I was a little bit late. But I hope that I'll have a little bit more time now to actually produce more accordion content. The site is... 95% there. It's making a few more connections, fixing the search, adding difficulty level, adding the forum where that's coming next week. But otherwise, I hope to be able to answer your questions more quickly now. Thank you. Thank you for coming. I hope you're well. Bye-bye. Thank you.